So earlier this week, I was in a barber's in Stoke-on-Trent. Not for a trim myself. I couldn't do that to Sharon. But to meet the man making a massive difference to the homeless community in Stoke-on-Trent by handing out free haircuts. All out of his own pocket. It was a busy morning at Chaxbarbers in Cobridge when I went to see them in action. I am on Waterloo Road. You've probably sat outside this barber's before because it is just by Cobridge Lights, opposite the turning to Festival Park. It's called Chaxbarbers and it is a busy barber shop. Take a listen to this. It is all going on. Morning, everyone.
Morning, everyone.
There we go, look. They're all in. We've got seven people in the chair. There's football shirts on the wall. They've got an arcade machine in here. And people are having all sorts of sharp haircuts around me right now. It's a proper hub of activity. Claire's in the chair. Going to have a chat with her in just a second. She's got nowhere to live at the moment and is getting a free haircut thanks to the owner of this place. It was Leroy, who is doing a cut on someone right now. He's probably fuming with me because he's been delayed already. But he is looking sharp. Leroy, what a thing you're doing here.
Good morning, good morning.
What a brilliant thing you're doing in this shop for homeless people.
Oh, thank you, thank you. Yeah, we're just trying to give back to the community as we come into this time of the month, time of the year. It's so cold. We just want to help as much as we can. Just give people a bit of boost towards their 2022.
Where did this idea come from?
You know, we just thought in Christmas time's a time to give, so I just thought it'd be something nice we can give as a team here at Chaxbarbers. Let's just try to offer something to people. We're going through sometimes what we don't know, so let's just try to help as much as we can.
The reaction of people is amazing. Just what a haircut means to them that we take for granted.
Oh, for real, yeah, for real. It can make such a difference. It can give someone confidence and get them to give them an opportunity as soon as they step out. So we're just trying to change people's lives as much as we can.
You're a busy shop, aren't you?
Yeah, it's pretty busy still, man. We're trying.
Honestly, this is a Thursday morning. It is ram. Business is good,
trying.
Yeah?
Yeah, we're just trying, you know. We just keep growing and keep working hard and see where we can go.
Leroy, I'll let you crack on. This gent's getting... He must be fuming with me. I'm sorry. I'm so sorry he's had to pause for the second time. Hi, Claire.
Hi.
How are you?
I'm all right.
What are you having done, Claire?
I'm having a bob.
All right, and you've got the clip in at the moment. Some of the cut's been done. Sandra is cutting your hair today.
Yeah.
Tell me a little bit about... How do you find out about this, by the way?
It was through Concrete, where I'm staying.
Concrete are brilliant, aren't they? Have they been a big help?
Yeah, they are brilliant. They are brilliant.
How have you found yourself without anywhere to live?
Me and my ex, well, it wasn't my ex, went around the neighbours, threatened them, which got me kicked out.
It can happen to anyone. What's the reality of that been like for you?
It's been horrible. Which made me realise he's not the man for me.
Been really tough.
Yeah. Been together 11 years, you know what I mean?
Yeah,
I mean, cut out my life, I've got nobody like, you know what I mean?
Getting your hair cut, something a lot of us, as I just said to Leroy, take for granted. How does that,
oh God,
how does that make you feel?
It makes me feel amazing.
Honestly, does it that mean that much to you?
Yeah.
What do you think it is, you know, just walking out of here with your hair done?
Yeah.
Do you think?
And meeting the few nice people in here.
It's lovely, isn't it?
Yeah.
They're really, really nice people.
Yeah, they are. You made me feel welcome and that, do you know what I mean?
Now, it's been about 6 months since you had it cut. You're going to look $1 million when you leave. And you've got some good news around the corner, I've heard.
Yes.
Tell me a little bit about what's going to be happening.
I'm going to be moving into my own place, so can't wait.
So you're getting your own place in about a week?
Yeah.
Just in time for Christmas?
Yeah.
How's that going to change your life?
Oh, Matt, it's going to change it so much. Look on the bright side now.
You've got beautiful blue eyes, haven't you? Look at them.
Thank you.
Hey?
Thank you.
Listen, Claire, enjoy feeling fabulous with your hair.
Yeah, I will.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
It's been great to meet you. She just said there, Leroy, how much it meant to her. She means the world to her, she said.
Oh, that's so beautiful. Thank you for that.
It is lovely.
That's what we want, you know.
Listen, at this
like
time of year, to do something like this, to give up your staff's time, I think it's magic.
For real.
So just well done, mate.
Thank you very much for that.
Thank you very much. What would you do with mine, by the way?
For you right now, we could just fix it up, you know, make it a bit sharp and crispy for you, yeah? So you can enter the new year nice and ready.
Top man, it's all going on. Christmas haircuts everywhere, party haircuts at Chaxbarbers. They're cutting homeless people's hair all day long today. They've got seven people coming in. What a magic thing to do at any time of year, but especially at Christmas.